Good morning. Welcome to a new session of this video classes. In this class, we will discuss about the Euler's equation for rigid body rotations and its consequences of the verification of law of conservation of energy and law of conservation of angular momentum. It means that we can able to derive or arrive or prove the law of conservation of kinetic energy and law of conservation of angular momentum by means of or from the Euler's equation for rigid body rotations. Right. First of all, what are Euler's equations? Okay. We know that in the year 1686, Sir Isaac Newton proposed three laws in order to describe the motion of particles. Okay, in the year 1686, Sir Isaac Newton proposed three laws in order to describe the motion of particles, which are very familiarly known as the Newton's laws of motion, law of inertia. Okay, the second law of Newton's second law, that is law of force, and the third one. Okay. About the action and reaction, okay, Newton's third law of motion. Right. After 50 years of Newton's proposal of the three laws, Euler proposed two laws, or Euler proposed a new law in order to extend the Newton's laws for particle motions to the rotational motion of rigid bodies. What is the thing? Euler proposed the laws after a century of Newton's laws, in order to extend the Newton's three laws from particle mechanics to the rigid body rotational mechanics. It means that the Euler's equations or Euler's laws are only for rigid body rotational motions. It is a simple extension of Newton's laws. Extension to the rotation of rigid body. Actually, Euler's rigid body equations are first order linear differential equations. They are first order linear differential equations, okay, used to describe the rotation of rigid body using a rotating frame of reference, with its axis fixed in the body and parallel to the principal axis of its inertia. Don't be clumsy about this one. I will explain very clearly. These Euler's laws are used to describe the rotation of the rigid body, about a rotating frame of reference, right? Rotating frame of reference using its axis fixed in the body. It means that there is an axis which is fixed in the rotating body itself, and these axes are parallel to the principal axis of inertia of the body, and this itself is a rotating frame of reference. It means that rotating frame of reference is there in the rotating body, and the rotations of now this rigid body is described with respect to another inertial frame, which is a fixed frame. This is the excellence of this Euler's equations. It means that Euler's equations gives the relation between rigid body mechanics or rigid body dynamics, okay, with respect to a fixed inertial body, with respect to a fixed inertial frame and another rotating frame, that is non-inertial frame, it gives the relation between the motion of the rigid body with respect to inertial frame and non-inertial frame. That's why it is having wide range of applications. Therefore, the Euler's equations can able to explain the complex nature of rigid body rotations. Okay, right. Euler's equations are first order linear differential equations, okay, relate the torque and change of angular momentum. Okay, they are again nothing but it gives the relation between torque and change of angular momentum. These equations gives a method to convert equation of motion of a rigid body from non-inertial frame to the inertial frame. This is very important thing. These equations gives a method to convert the equation of motion of a rigid body from non-inertial frame to the inertial frame. Okay, inertial frame means a fixed frame. Non-inertial frame means a rotating frame. Right. Again, I am telling to you that this non-inertial frame is fixed in the rotating body itself. Body rotates and a frame is fixed in that body. Therefore, that frame itself is a non-inertial frame and the rotations of this body will be measured by means of or described by means of with respect to a non-inertial frame. Right. Therefore, we have a provision or we have a way or we have a method to convert the equation of motion of rigid body from non-inertial frame to the inertial frame or inertial frame to the non-inertial frame. Right. When axes are attached to the rotating body, right, what I said just it is this one. When axes are attached to a rotating body, these axes also rotates with the body and so these are known as the non-inertial frame. Right. Then we can transform the equation of motion of rotating body from body coordinates. What are body coordinates here? Non-inertial coordinate for frame to the space coordinates, that is the inertial frame. Okay. As an axis system is attached to the rotating body itself, that axis system is a non-inertial frame. They are the body coordinates. Okay. Now we can these equations of motion can transfer the body coordinates to the space coordinates. Space coordinate means an inertial frame. An inertial frame. I will give you a best example. Earth always rotates around the sun. Sun is considered as a fixed frame. That is an inertial frame. Now the rotating Earth will be an example for non-inertial frame because if we consider a frame of reference or an axis system on the Earth, as it always rotates around the sun, okay, Earth's surface is a non-inertial rotating frame with respect to the inertial frame, that is the sun. Therefore, we can describe the rotations of Earth, which is within the brackets a rigid body, with respect to a non-inertial frame, with respect to an inertial frame, which is the sun. Similarly, here also, in case of every rigid body, there is a body coordinates and there is a inertial frame. Body coordinates are non-inertial frame fixed in the rotating body itself. Inertial coordinates are, or inertial frame of reference is some fixed frame of reference, okay, in outside the system or in the space. Right. This can be done by an equation, that is d by dt of something with space coordinates is equal to d by dt of the same thing with body coordinates plus omega into that particular quantity. Have you understand it? D by dt of a physical quantity with respect to space is equal to d by dt of the same physical quantity with respect to body plus omega into that physical quantity, because this is a non-inertial frame, this is an inertial frame, and in addition to the inertial frame measurements, you will get to omega into that physical quantity. Right. We know that torque tau is equal to rate of change of angular momentum. Therefore, tau bar is equal to dl bar by dt. We will apply the same thing here. Therefore, dl bar by dt space, it means that rate of change of angular momentum with space coordinates is equal to rate of change of angular momentum with body coordinates plus omega bar into l bar, omega bar into l bar. It means that this is a mathematical operation and this is operating on l bar. Therefore, d by da, dl bar by dt space is equal to dl bar by dt body plus omega bar into l bar. Okay, right. This is the space coordinates, and it means that non-inertial frame of, this is the measurement of non-inertial frame of reference. This is the inertial, this is the inertial frame of reference, and this is the non-inertial frame of reference, or this is the fixed frame, this is rotating frame, okay, plus omega bar plus l bar, right, okay. Yeah, this is an inertial frame or inertial measurement with respect to a fixed body. Therefore, this is nothing but the external torque. This is nothing but the external torque. Therefore, external torque tau bar is equal to dl bar by dt, that is within the body coordinates, plus omega bar cross l bar. Right. Now, tau bar is equal to dl bar by dt plus omega bar plus omega bar cross l bar is equal to determinant of ijk. Omega 1, omega 2, omega 3, L1, L2, L3. Okay, right. Here, 1, 2, 3 are the body axis. Instead of writing x, y, z, actually, the axis are designated with the x, y, z, x, y, z axis. But for the sake of simplicity, okay, they are here simply termed as 1, 2, 3. They are body coordinates. They are fixed in the body. Please remember that one. Right. The rotation around the first axis of rotation, if you consider the rotation around the first axis only, only first axis, then we are considering the rotation of the body about the first axis only, that is the x axis only, then the magnitude of the torque, okay, first axis means magnitude of the torque, tau 1, magnitude only, tau 1 is equal to dl1 by dt plus, okay, first axis, therefore you will get omega 2 L3, omega 2 L3 minus omega 3 L2, right. Now, tau 1 is equal to, L is equal to I omega, therefore L1 is equal to I1 omega 1, therefore I1 d omega 1 by dt, plus L3 is equal to I3 omega 3, L2 is equal to I2 omega 2, right. Here, omega 2, omega 3 are common factors, then you will get to tau 1, that is the magnitude of torque when the body rotates about the first axis or about the x axis, is torque tau 1 is equal to I1 d omega 1 by dt plus I3 minus I2 into omega 2 omega 3. Okay, let this is the torque acting on the body, when the body rotates about the first axis or the x axis. Similarly, if you take other two axes also individually, then for all the three axes, again I will write, for all the three axes, tau 1 is equal to I1 d omega 1 plus I3 minus I2, okay, into omega 2 omega 3. Tau 2 is equal to I2 d omega 2 dt plus, okay, what is this one? Tau 1 is equal to actually I3 minus I2, reverse arc is coming, therefore, okay, actually I3 minus I1, but it is I1 minus I3 into omega 1 omega 3. Tau 3 is equal to I3 into d omega 3 dt plus I2 minus I1 into omega 1 omega 3. These are the, okay, Euler's equation of rotation of a rigid body, which connects the torque acting on the body, okay, with respect to an inertial frame to the, this is the torque acting on the non-inertial frame and the additional terminology. Then once, of course, then this is converted into the true designation of axis x, y, z. This is tau x is equal to ix plus d omega x by dt plus, okay, I3 means iz minus iy, omega and similarly you will get all these things. But actually this is not the proper order. Proper order is x, y, z, and z, x, y. Okay, that's why in order to get a symmetry, we will do this one. We will take a minus negative as a common here. Therefore, you will get ix d omega x by dt minus, right. Now, this is the other, iy minus iz into omega y omega z. Tau y is equal to iy d omega y by dt minus, okay. When iy, y axis, therefore, iz minus ix, rotation, okay. Omega x, omega z. Iz, tau z is equal to iz d omega z by dt minus z axis, therefore, ix minus ig, iy into omega x, omega y. Okay. These are the original form, or the Euler's equation, which describes the motion of a rigid body, and it relates the motion of a rigid body from inertial frame, that is the fixed frame, to the rotating frame, that is the body frame. Okay. If the body rotates freely, body rotates freely means tau 1 is equal to tau 2 is equal to tau 3. Okay, no torque is acting. Okay, right. This is a special case for that one. But anyhow, these are the Euler's equations. Alright. Now, by means of this Euler's equations, I said that Euler's equations are, okay, very significant equations, and they can able to explain any complex nature of the rotation of the rigid bodies. Okay, they itself have the convenience of conversion of the measurements, or the conversion of the rotation of the body from inertial frame to the non-inertial frame. Therefore, they can solve any problem related to the rigid body rotations, and they can also, okay, helpful to derive all the other things that are related to the rigid body rotation. That's why, okay, such of things now we will discuss, that is conservation of energy and conservation of angular momentum from Euler's equations. Okay, it means that now we are going to derive or prove the conservation of energy and conservation of angular momentum from Euler's equations. Okay, it means that Euler's equations can do so many things. They can produce the conservation of energy, they can produce the conservation of angular momentum, and they can explain the complex nature of any complex nature of rigid body rotation. Okay, right. Now the thing is, for conservation of energy. What is conservation of energy? Conservation of energy means when no external torque is acting. Okay. Here, in case of rotations, when no external torque is acting on the system or acting on the body, then its kinetic energy remains constant. That is the law of conservation of energy as far as the rotations of the rigid body is concerned. Law of conservation of energy states that when no external force is acting, the energy remains constant there. Here, no external torque is acting, the total kinetic energy remains constant. Okay, that we will prove, or we will arrive this one. Okay, right. Then now, what is the hypothesis we have to do, or what is the postulate, or what is the beginning with which we have to start this one? Torque is zero when no torque is acting. Tau is 0. When tau is 0, tau 1 is 0, tau 2 is 0, tau 3 is 0. What are tau 1, tau 2, tau 3? They are the magnitudes of the torques acting on the rigid body with respect to the first axis, with respect to the second axis, with respect to the third axis, or with respect to the x axis, y axis, and z axis. Okay? Right. When also, what is this one? When torque acting on the action of rotating body is 0, okay, all these things will be 0. Therefore, you will get this one. Okay? Right. The same thing I have written here, I1 d omega 1, okay, instead of x, y, z, I1 1, 2, 3 notation is written here, I1 d omega 1 dt minus I2 minus I3 into omega 2 omega 3 is equal to 0, similarly the other two equations also, right. Now, multiply equation 1 with omega 1, equation 2 with omega 2, equation 3 with omega 3, and add all these things, right, I1 omega 1 d omega 1 dt, right, I2 omega 2 d omega 2 d3, I3 omega 3 d omega 3 d3, plus Okay, here omega 1, here omega 2, here omega 3. You will get 2 terms here, you will get 2 terms here, you will get 2 terms here. For all 6 terms, so omega 1, omega 2, omega 3 are the common. And okay, there are 3 positive terms and there are 3 negative terms. And all these terms will cancel. When the first one is multiplied with omega 1, and the second one is multiplied with omega 2, and the third one is multiplied with omega 2. Therefore, all these things will become 0. Therefore, the RHS is also 0. Therefore, I1 omega 1 d omega 1 dt plus I2 omega 2 d omega 2 dt plus I3 omega 3 d omega 3 dt is equal to 0. Now, this can be written as half into, half into d by dt of I1 omega 1 square, okay. Let us observe this one. D by dt of I1 omega 1 square is equal to I1 is constant, it comes out. When differentiated, you will get 2 omega 1 d omega 1 by dt. Am I correct? 2 omega 1 d omega 1 by dt into I1. Therefore, 2 2 will cancel. Therefore, I1 omega 1 d omega by dt, you will get this term. Okay, therefore, this term is nothing but half d by dt of I1 omega 1 square. Similarly, this term is half d by dt of I2 omega 2 square. And similarly, this term is nothing but half d by dt of I2 omega 3 square. Okay, of course, this is equal to 0. Right, what is this one? I1 omega 1 square. Okay, when this half goes inside, half I omega 1 square is equal to kx or k1. Half I omega 2 square is equal to k2 or ky. Half I omega 3 square is equal to kz. Okay, this is k1, k2, k3 or kj, kx, ky, kz. Therefore, this is nothing but d by dt of kx, ky, kz is equal to 0. Okay, kx means kinetic energy with respect to the first axis, second axis, z axis. Therefore, there is total. Therefore, that is nothing but the kinetic and total kinetic energy. D by dt of kinetic energy is equal to 0. Differentiation of something is 0. It means that something is constant. It means that k is equal to constant. It means that kinetic energy is equal to constant. What is kinetic energy? Kinetic energy of the rigid body is constant. When no external torque is acting. Therefore, when no external torque is acting, the kinetic energy of the rigid body remains constant, which is nothing but the law of conservation of energy. Which is nothing but the law of conservation of energy. Okay? Right. Next, law of conservation of angular momentum. Right. Same. What is law of conservation of angular momentum? The angular momentum of a rotating body, rotating rigid body remains constant when no torque is acting. When no torque is acting, okay, the body rotates with the same angular momentum. It means that its angular momentum remains constant. Therefore, again, okay, torque tau is equal to 0. Right. Take the same set of equations. Now you please multiply the first one with I1 omega 1, second one I2 omega 2, third one I3 omega 3. Therefore, okay, when once this is multiplied with I1 omega 1, you will get I1 square omega 1 d omega 1 dt. Am I correct? Right? I1 square omega 1 d omega 1 by dt plus I2 square omega 2 d omega 2 by dt. Here it is a mistake. D omega 2 by dt plus I3 square omega 3 d omega by d3 less so, okay. With what we will multiply it? We multiply it with I1 omega 1, I2 omega 2, I3 omega 3. Here you will get omega 1, omega 2, omega 3, omega 1, omega 1, omega 3. Here also this one, okay. Here I multiplied with I1, multiplied with I2, multiplied with I3. Again you will get 6 terms in which three are positive terms and identical other three are negative terms. Therefore, again, when multiplied with the respective equations, first with I1 omega 1, second with I2 omega 2, third with I3 omega 3, all these 6 terms will cancel together and therefore, now this is equal to 0. Again, similarly, this can be also written as half into d by dt of, same thing, I1 omega 1 square plus I2 omega 2 square plus I2 omega 3 square is equal to 0. Okay, right, sorry. Okay, please come to this point. Okay, I1 square omega, okay, when once, what is this one? Multiplied with I1 omega 1, I2 omega 2, I2 omega 2, all these three terms will cancel. And as we multiply with I1 omega 1 square, you will get I1 square omega 1, d omega 1 dt, the psi 2 square omega 2 d omega 2 by dt, the psi 3 square omega 2 d omega 3 by dt is equal to 0. Now this will be written as half into d by dt of I1 square into omega 1 square. Please expand this one. And once this one is expanded, I1 square comes out. Okay, d by dt of omega 1 square is equal to 2 omega 1 d omega 1 by dt. That 2 and this 2 will cancel. Therefore, you will get I1 square omega 1 d 1 d omega 1 by dt. Therefore, the other terms also. Therefore, now this can be written as half into d by dt of I1 square omega 1 square plus I2 square omega 2 square plus I3 square omega 3 square is equal to 2 square. This is nothing but L is equal to I omega. This is nothing but L1 square. This is nothing but L2 square. This is nothing but L3 square. Or this is Lx square. This is Ly square. This is Lz square. Okay, Lx square plus Ly square plus Lz square is equal to L square. Therefore, half into d by dt of L square is equal to 0. Okay, right. This half will move this side. And it comes when this one is differentiated, you will get to. Okay, you will get 2L d by dt. That 2 and this 2 will cancel and you will get L d by dt is equal to 0. Right. L d by dt is equal to 0 means either L has to become 0 or dl by dt is 0. That is L, angular momentum. Angular momentum for rotating body, the angular momentum. There is some angular momentum. Therefore, the angular momentum never becomes 0. Therefore, what is the other option? Dl by dt must be 0. If dl by dt is equal to 0, or if something, the differentiation of something is 0, that something is constant. It means that L is constant. Therefore, okay, law of conservation of angular momentum can be easily obtained from Euler's equations, because law of conservation of angular momentum states that the angular momentum of a rotating rigid body remains constant when no external torque is acting. Thus, we can, okay, very simply and very straightforwardly prove law of conservation of kinetic energy and law of conservation of angular momentum in case of rigid body rotations. Okay, right. This is about the Euler's equations and its two applications. Okay, see you in the next class.